John Key appears to have won over his Sri Lankan host during this weekend's Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting, and New Zealand is being rewarded with an elephant.
The unusual gift is being signalled as a symbol of the two countries' friendship. Basil Rajapaksa, Sri Lanka's Economic Development Minister and brother of the President, told TB1's Q&A about the arrangement. Our political editor Corin Dan joins us now live from Colombo. Corin.
Yes, well, Prime Minister John Key will hold bilateral talks with Mahinda Rajapaksa about now, and you can expect human rights will be certainly raised there, but perhaps a little bit more uncomfortable for John Key now with this offer of an elephant, because New Zealand has taken a softer stance on issues such as war crimes here, so critics may argue we're now becoming too close a buddy to Sri Lanka.
Holding court with foreign media and batting back growing calls for an independent war crimes inquiry.
So why the international community is only asking for one side? But even then, we have had several inquiries, and we have punished the people who had violated the Sri Lankan laws.
Mr. Rajapaksa, pushing a reconciliation model like the one used in post-apartheid South Africa as the best way to move on from the government's bloody 30-year civil war with Tamil separatists in the north. New Zealand, unlike the UK, also not seeing a need for an inquiry.
There's always got to be a degree of looking back if you're going to have successful reconciliation. And it's not that people who undertake, you know, war crimes shouldn't be held to account. They should, actually. But on the other side of the coin, this was a very, very bloody civil war.
But I appreciate the New Zealand government position, and especially the Prime Minister and the Foreign Minister.
Relations between the two countries now set to be marked in a special way.
We are trying to send a symbol also very soon, a Sri Lankan elephant for one of your zoo.
Human rights activists, however, are unlikely to be impressed by the gesture.
There are appalling human rights abuses happening still today. These abuses have to be confronted. Yes, there's a diplomatic way to do that, but he's not even doing that.
Just last week, a New Zealand Green MP was briefly detained in Sri Lanka whilst trying to highlight concerns about human rights. The incident put down to a visa issue.
If she wants to come, she can come in a proper way, legal way.
John Key accepts that explanation and wasn't planning to raise the issue at today's meeting with the President. Corin Dan, One News, Colombo.
Yeah, well, Auckland Zoo, we understand, has been working for a couple of years now to try and get this Sri Lankan elephant here. But certainly, make no mistake, that would not happen without authorisation from the Sri Lankan government. A bit like, if you like, say, a panda coming from China. So a bit of a bolt from the blue that's now being tied, in some ways, by Basil Rajapaksa to New Zealand's relationship with Sri Lanka. Now, in terms of the CHOGM meeting here, that is wrapped up, pretty much wrapped up. And Sri Lanka will be happy because it's proved it can hold a large event despite just 4 years on from the Civil War. In terms of New Zealand, though, I think this meeting was really about a chance to lobby for that UN Security Council seat and secure up concerns around the volatile dairy trade here in Sri Lanka.
Thank you. That's Corin Dan, live from Colombo in Sri Lanka.